more.
Oh, so where are we headed?
That's a good question. I got a couple options.
I haven't decided yet.
Let's do this.
Okay, so turn it on.
Yo, cover on it.
You gotta actually reach inside and hold that. There's okay. Two buttons there. This is on, this is off. You gotta hold it.
Is it good?
Yeah.
It's on. I think it's just turn it on. Maybe.
Yeah. Just look down. You don't have to look. Simple enough, right?
Yeah.
See, this is a little different safety. It's up here on top. Well, that's a slick little game.
It is.
I was on it the whole time. Nice job, pal.
That 410 waxes, doesn't it?
Pretty neat.
I like how small and compact it is.
Yeah.
It's a nice gun. Heck yeah, buddy.
Come on, let's check.
Well, that's pretty big. Oh, wow.
That beard.
That's a long one.
Boy, we got a treat, didn't we?
Yeah.
I didn't think he was going to come at first.
Night before the season, I've been scouting for better part of 2 days now. We just came to this farm I've hunted in the past and actually found some turkey sign. So there's some turkeys around, it's just there's not a ton, and it's a lot of area they're covering right now. For whatever reason, they're bouncing around, so we're just poking around trying to get the most up-to-date intel we can, and hopefully we can get one to gobble this evening here in a few hours and get on something for first thing in the morning. But it's gonna be a bit of a challenge, but we're gonna give it a go and see how it goes. Keep walking, keep scouting.
That's another 300 yards.
He's far in there. see if Jay saw anything. I don't think that's a bad play. That bird's probably 200 to 300 yards off the property line, but I'll have to yelp him in. Or at least try to. Gotta get out of here and get some food and get to bed. Finally, we get to chase turkeys tomorrow. So, either the bird that Jay heard last night isn't here, or he's not gobbling, or he, we don't know. There's no bird where we thought there was. There's one down a good ways off the property, gobbling pretty good, but he's probably 500 yards and we can't go after him, so probably gonna just move around this farm a little bit. Then maybe, I don't know, see if we can find something else and hit up a couple other spots. We'll see what happens. He attracted us, but we didn't close the distance. I think another hen came up the ridge and got with him. He shut up, but we kind of poked around down where he was. That bird's been there the last couple days, so if we don't, well, either way, we'll probably be in here in the morning. Kind of have an idea of what he's doing now, so we're going to keep bouncing around and check a couple other spots. We have about 3 hours left, so we'll see what we can do the rest of the day. Standing here listening. He's in a different area than he has been the last two mornings or nights, but that'll be okay, I think. We're just gonna listen. There may actually be more than one bird in here, so we gotta get this figured out because we gotta kill him in the morning. Get her done in Ohio. Or not. Doesn't matter. We're just trying to have fun out here, right, Jared?
Yeah, that's the plan.
Give him a smile.
Show him them teeth, baby.
Side, bro.
Just him again.
Let's keep. That could be a dead bird.
So this, like, logging road that we're on right here, goes on this whole property edge down here.
Yeah.
Once you get down in here, it's kind of like this little like field right here, and these are just kind of like little islands in here.
Yeah.
So it's just like open, these like in between these little clumps right here, is the same as this logging road. Okay. So when you get down.
Yeah, click on that so that thing's on.
So when you get down like right here, yeah. The pin's off a tiny bit. He's actually in this tree right here, and he can see on this thing right here.
Okay.
So if we set up right here on this point right here, and we put the decoy right here,
yeah.
We'll kind of be shaded a little bit by this, but you'll see the decoy straight right here.
Alright.
And when he flies down.
Zoom up for a sec?
What?
Zoom up for a sec?
I got right to him.
How far were you from?
Probably about 70 yards.
Yeah, you can see him silhouette.
Yeah, yes.
Was he strutting? Or?
No, that's the thing. I kept wanting to see him puff up, but every time
he would gobble.
Yeah, he gobbled. So nice. That was that. So, like I'm saying, if we get right in, I got a spot I picked out in the morning, we can look at it. But if we just put the decoy right there.
So what are we going to be like 40 yards from, something like that?
No, we're going to be
probably, we're still going to be 70 yards from him or whatever, because he's just over this edge. But I'm telling you, he's just going to fly right down in this stuff right here. And if he does fly on this little trail right here too, you'll be able to see that also. So no matter what.
How far? Is it flat there or is it starting to roll off?
It's kind of, it goes flat or whatever, probably about like 40 yards, and then it rolls off a little bit.
All right, we had some weather overnight, and we're still into it a little bit. We had some wind and rain. Hoping we can keep the camera gear dry, keep us dry, keep the bird happy enough to come in. So we're just pulling in now. We're gonna get set up. Hopefully we don't get a downpour. Ready to fly down time. We'll see how it goes today. Oh, last morning here. So we're gonna do what we can. All right, just pulled in. Sneak in there. Get real tight to this bird. We're not gonna do a lot of talking or moving once we get there. So we're gonna be within sight of him. And hopefully he flies down, we bust him. Head back to New Hampshire. Hopefully it's a good hunt. To our left. Don't move. I don't know. I heard him spit. He's coming from our left. Don't move. Don't move. Don't move. From our left. Hard. He's running. Don't move. Don't move. Don't move. Tell me when you got him. Do you have him?
Yep.
You got him?
Yep.
100%. Okay. That's a good shot. Yes. I didn't think that was gonna happen.
Oh, man. I love it. What we live
for. First one of the year, man. That was just awesome. He played the game.
She was coming in, my hands were like this. Down
you gotta thank that hen.
Oh, dude, I saw a hen cub. I'm like, oh, here we go. Yep. He's like, cameras, I'm like, all right, we're in good shape. That is freaking sweet, man. That's Ohio bird down. We had a, I don't know, I didn't know if it was gonna happen. It was like a 50-50 thing. These birds are not easy. You gotta play the game right if you wanna kill them. But, oh, it's a good feeling, first bird down this year. Gotta thank Jay and Chris for coming out, helping me out. And definitely Jared Hawkins for, you know, putting me on his property, so. Really appreciate what him and the Hawkins family do for me. Awesome, awesome, awesome. All right, let's go check them out. Like an Ohio 2-year-old. Oh, it's not that light. Nothing heavier than I thought. I know. Sweet. 7 o'clock. Packed up now, we're gonna get in the truck, head home to New Hampshire. I'm really glad we killed early because the winds picked up here today. It was gonna make it hard to chase birds. It was awesome to get an early start here in Ohio. John got an early start in Tennessee, but we are headed to New England and the Northeast. That's our bread and butter. We're gonna kick it off in New York and in New Hampshire next weekend with the youth hunt. Then we're on to Massachusetts, New Hampshire, Vermont, Maine, PA, all those states. So it's going to be fast and furious from here on out. But awesome start to the season. Awesome time in Ohio, as always. And I can't wait to see what the rest of the year holds for us.